Gregory 12s, welcome to the following lesson on insurance. So in the previous period we started the discussion on insurance. We talked about a few aspects, definitions, terminology, and today we're going to be continuing on that. We're going to build on the foundation that we laid yesterday. So if you're not certain about something, please go revise by watching the video again, or you can direct your questions to me. Okay, so this is the second video, and after this video and after this topic, you should be able to give examples of short-term and long-term insurance. You should be able to mention or name or discuss or explain the principles of insurance, the indemnity or indemnification, security or certainty, utmost good faith or insurable interest. Or sometimes you have to compare indemnity versus security versus utmost good faith, etc. You should also be able to apply the average clause to calculate the compensation that we did yesterday. You should be able to discuss the advantages or importance of insurance. You should be able to explain the meaning of insurable versus non-insurable risk, and then give examples of these type of risks. So let's jump in. Start with terms and definitions. So what is short and long-term insurance, the principles, why it's important to have insurance, and the different types of risks. Okay, so this is just a recap. So insurance is a contract between a person or a business, which we call the insured, that requires insurance cover or cover against the risk. And the company that provides that cover or bears that risk is then the insurance company, the insurer. And in order then to have to carry that risk, they will require that the insured pay a monthly amount or annual amount, and that is a premium. Okay, the contract is the insurer undertakes to indemnify. This is a word that is described below, which means to compensate, protect or repay the insured in the event of a loss or damage. So where the insured undertakes to protect or repay or compensate the insured in the event of a specific loss. And for that, you have to pay a monthly premium. Insurer, it's the company that will take over specific risk or specified risk. The insured is the business taking out the insurance or the person. Insured value means the amount of money that you agree to in order to take out insurance, and that can be on assets or life, whatever is the terms that you that will be negotiated. Book value. This is the purchase price of an asset minus your depreciation. So that's the value, the current value of it. Means as your car gets older, its value decreases. So they'll take the purchase price minus depreciation to get the actual value of the car. Premium or risk. Risk is the possibility of losses or damage. Premium is the payment made by the insured to be covered in the event of losses. Life insurance is a long-term insurance and taken out on the life of a human being and covered for the loss of life. Public liability. This is one that we'll be doing in one of the videos that will follow. This is damage caused by business operations to the public. Okay, that's the important one. And insurable interest is expressed in financial terms, and it is the interest that the insured stand to lose if there are losses or damage. Now let's take this as our stance for the lesson. If you want to take out insurance on your car, right, there's many options. You can take a third party, or you can take out a full insurance package, which means even if you bump it, whatever, you are covered. It will be repaired. Now, a question that a lot of people ask is, now let's say my car breaks, I've got a breakdown next to the road. Okay, the insurance company you'll phone them, they'll arrange for towage, if that is what you ask for or specified in the contract, and then they'll help sort you out. But now there comes a time where you have to maintain your car, take it for a service. That is not part of an insured event. That is not something you take out insurance on. If you did not maintain your car properly, and that was the cause of the problem of the car, let's say it's a new car, you haven't serviced it, and now you drive and then suddenly something breaks, the insurance company will assist up until a point, but they you will really have to motivate why it was an insured event. Okay, so they you have to prove, and that's of provide evidence, and we'll get to that a bit later. So sorry, short-term versus long-term insurance. Short-term insurance is property insurance. It's money in transit, theft, burglary, fire. That is things that happens on a daily basis that you take out insurance for, or make sure that if something happens you are covered for, in the event, for example, fire or burglary. Long-term insurance is something that you set up, for example, let's say in the distant future I want to make sure that I've got life insurance, or I take out life cover, or I'll take out a pension fund or a provident fund. So at a specific age it will pay out the amount that you wanted to receive in that period. So this is why it's called investments. Okay, it's still insurance, but it's now it's an investment into managing your risks. Okay. Disability, that's where you want to ensure that should something happen to you, you are in a car crash or an accident, and then you are disabled, which means you can't work as you normally would have been able to work. It means you can't do the work as well as you previously could, or can't do the same work. That means you'll now be covered, and depending on the policy, you will be compensated accordingly. Okay, so there's many different types of insurance. You need to be able to mention, name, or give examples. Now let's delve into the principles of insurance. The first one is indemnification, or indemnity. Now what does that mean? If you indemnify someone, now let's start with that. It's a short-term insurance. Okay, and the insured is compensated for a specified or a proven harm or loss. Okay, so this is an example, or this principle is normally applied to short-term insurance. Now, this is what it means. The insurer agrees to compensate the insured for damages, losses specified, in return for premiums paid by the insured to the insurer. This is insurance is based upon. That's one of the principles that how insurance works and how it will continue to work. So they will bear the risk in order that you don't have to bear the risk or worry about it all day or night, but then in return for them taking over the risk, you will pay them a specified amount. Now I read up a bit about it, and one of the earliest stories of insurance was with the ships merchants. It was in a time where there was a lot of piracy, physical piracy, so they had a lot of risk of standing to lose their ship, their merchandise, and then they would it almost happened in a fashion of betting. And then they would almost bet that it would happen with them. And then one person, the insurer, would then say, okay, let's give out insurance to them. I'm not sure what they called it back then. But he knew it was not 10 out of 10 ships that were robbed. And he knew the percentage. So let's say 4 out of the 10 was robbed, and then he needed to make sure that he could compensate those 4 ships. But then that means the other 6 ships that paid him for insurance, He would take their money. So that's how it started, and it just continued to grow. Or that's an earlier story. Okay, another thing, it protects the insured against a specified event that that will occur. So in that case, it was that they will be robbed. In our case, it can be against being in a car accident, or sometimes even if you take out a building insurance, that for landslides or earthquake, that your house is damaged and then you are insured against that, or fire, whatever. Okay, payouts. Now, when a company will, if you take an insurance, you will require a payout, and they will make payouts if you can provide proof that a specific event took place and you can prove the amount of the loss or damage. Now, a friend of mine recently, he woke up one morning, 5 o'clock, with the a smell of thick smoke. So he woke his wife, they grabbed the kids and they ran outside, and just in time, because their Wendy house was suddenly on fire, and that was attached to their house on the one side. It was just a separate Wendy house, but it was standing next to it, and that started to the wall caught fire after being exposed to the fire for such a time. And they phoned the department, the fire department. They came out, they put out the fire, but this Wendy house was destroyed. Now you think, you know, it's a Wendy house. That's a shame. In this Wendy house was all his cycling gear, his running gear, his camping gear, everything. And that amounted to, let's use a figurative amount of 200,000, which was quite a lot, which he didn't have to replace everything with. So luckily he did have insurance, but the Wendy house was not specified as part of buildings. Okay, they see it as a separate building, and that meant that when the payout, when they came for the payout, they said, okay, you gave us proof that the Wendy house was there. It's not part of the buildings, but let's look at the others. Maybe we can help you with specified items. So he said, okay, so he showed them photos of everything. Luckily, he cleaned the place the previous weekend, and he took photos to show his parents how he reorganized the place. So he had evidence of everything. And then they said, okay, provide us evidence of your mountain bike. Now he had a carbon. He had three carbon mountain bikes, well, one mountain bike and two road bikes, and that was burnt carbon, is totally destroyed in fire, so there was nothing, no proof. So we showed them where his jockey was and pieces of metal of the wheel, and then they said, but we don't see a frame, so we can't pay you for the frame. So we lost out on that. In the end, I think he's still busy with the claim. He's still trying to fight or to get compensation for that. But that's the part of insurance. It's such a big thing that you need to insure for everything and make sure that everything is specified. That there's still a lot of risk if you don't do it properly. So the end result is that if you can't provide proof, you will not be compensated, even if it means that it did happen, but you can't provide proof. Okay. Then the amount of indemnification is limited to the amount of provable damage, even if your insurance policy or contract is higher. So even if he took out insurance for R1 million on contents, then they would only pay out the amount of proven damage that they can see. Okay, so let's say his mountain bike was worth 100,000 and they can't find the frame, then sorry, that 100,000 doesn't count. Okay, trust you get the idea. The insured must be placed in the same position as before, and he may not profit from insurance. Okay, that's the one of the other principles. It's you must be in the same place, not better off or not worse off. Okay, second one, security or certainty. Now, this is more a long-term insurance where the insurer undertakes to pay out an agreed amount upon the event of loss of or life or retirement or whatever circumstance that you specify. Okay, so this is, as you can see, 2070, that is exactly 50 years from now, and if I live another 50 years, that means I will be well into my 80s, and hopefully I'll still be active and teaching. It would be brilliant. Okay, a predetermined amount will be paid out when the insured reaches a predetermined age or gets injured due to a predetermined event. Okay, that's another part of security or certainty. And the aims is to provide financial security to the insured at retirement or to the dependents of the deceased. Okay, you want to retire nice and have some sort of financial security. Okay, last, third one is utmost good faith. Now, this is all about when you take out insurance policy, you are supplying them with all the information you can. But when the claim comes, now that's the temptation or the tempting part. So let's say you're in a car accident, right? And your car bonnet is massively damaged and they need to repair it or give you a new bonnet. And they, let's say your bumper is irreparable, but the rest is fine, your wheels are fine. But now, due to this accident, you had a rim that was damaged prior. You had you hit a pothole and you didn't have insurance for that. You fixed the tire, but your rim was still damaged. Now, do you disclose that? That is the one of the principles. So you have to be honest in supplying details when taking out insurance contract. And you must disclose all relevant facts regarding the accident as well, so that everything can be examined according to the risk. Now, let's say it was just the front part of the car and you start claiming for scratches on the side. Okay, that is not acceptable, and I'm not sure what if there's penalties, but if you give any false information and it comes to light, it will lead into your claim not being processed or being compensated for that. Okay, so you should be giving all information that is accurate and truth. There's a lot of examples of where people try to extort insurance companies, and then most of them are caught out, and then it becomes a public, almost like a public matter. One thing, the insurance premiums normally increase year on year due to people trying to make money from insurance contracts. That is not something to consider. Definitely not. It's not part of an ethical point of doing business or personal way of doing life. Okay, what is insurable interest? That means you must prove that you will suffer a financial loss if the insured object is damaged or lost or it ceases to exist. So you must prove that there's some sort of damage or financial loss that you will suffer. Give evidence again. Now, the insured insurable interest must be expressed in financial terms. You must be able to say, okay, my car is valued at 200,000 rand. If something should happen, I need to be compensated for that. And that is 200,000 rand. Okay, again, there must be a legal relationship between the insured object and the contract. Okay, so let's say I've got a car. The legal relationship means the car is on me, on my name. Okay, I can't claim for my father-in-law's car. There's no legal relationship. There's nothing that binds us. But if it's yours, if it's on your name, if it's specified in your policy, then there's that relationship. Okay, and remember, just as a last note, insurance is there not to make a profit from it, but to be in the same position as you were before you took out insurance. Okay. So, what's the advantages of importance of insurance for businesses? So, one, it transfers the risk. So, risk is transferred from the business or from the person to the company. They carry the risk and the transfer of risk is subject to the terms and conditions. Okay, so your risk is carried, but there's certain limitations or T's and C's that's linked to it. And that will also come into play with calculation of your premium, as well as how much excess you will have to pay, as well as what criteria do you need to supply details with for your compensation. It protects business against dishonest employees, against losses due to death of a debtor, against theft or losses of stock or damages caused by natural disasters like floods, storms, fires, etc. Protects business from claims made by members of public for damages that the business is responsible for. This is now what I referred to earlier in as public liability. So you need to be able to, let's say someone walks into your company. There was a slippery when wet sign, the lady or the man fell, and now they want to sue you. Okay, if you took out public insurance liability, then you will probably be covered to cover their medical costs or whatever. Okay, so it's important to be covered. So it protects the business. So there's a transfer of risks and it protects the business. But now let's sketch another scenario. Let's say your business is open and someone comes in. There's no guns, there's no action, there's no specific event. A guy just takes a chocolate bar and he goes. And the next day another person comes in and he steals, he's shoplifting. And so it continues, and at the end of the month you realize, yo, there's a lot of stock that has disappeared. And in your research or in your auditing, you find out, you know, it was shoplifting. That is not a specified event, and you will not be compensated for it. That's why there's security cameras or security guards. But again, you can't quantify that as well beforehand. That is an event that happens, and there's no specifications to it. But on the other hand, if your business is closed, or let's say your business is open, but the guy comes in with a gun, shoots holes in your ceiling and demands all the money in your in the cash in the till, then you need that will be covered. If you take out that cover, there's a cover that will cover you for that or the event of that. So I hope that makes sense. Okay, you will be covered for, a business will be compensated for insurable losses. Okay, that's, you need to be able to prove that you will suffer in the event of something that happens. For example, destruction of property. Okay, we continue on. Business assets, you will be insured against damage or theft. Now, if you didn't take out insurance for your car or your business premises or your equipment, then if something happens, let's say fire occurs, then you're on your own. There's no cost for to replace that. There's no assistance for you. You carry the full risk of replacement or repairs. Now, if there's fire, normally you can't repair everything and you have to do everything from scratch. So just think, let's say you started a business and you didn't take out insurance due to the high premiums, but something bad happens, then you will have to almost start over again. Okay. There was a business a local business that had a bad run in due to Eskom and load shedding, and they had stock that was perishable, and due to the electricity failures and without any backup power supplies, the business ran into a lot of financial physical stock losses, which they had to just throw away. And in the event, they were stuck in insurance claims. Now that's something that it's difficult to determine beforehand, and you need to take insurance and consider all the different things that might happen. Okay. Businesses are protected against a loss of earnings, for example, let's say strikes at the company, and that can result in losses worth millions. So in the automotive industry, that's a thing that businesses should take the insurance on, because strikes are a thing that happens it's not abnormal, it's quite the norm for people to strike there. So in the time where the business is not functioning, you need to be able to protect yourself against that. And as they're striking, that means they're not working. That means you need to be able to make sure that you hire more. You need to be able to hire more temporary workers, and when you've to cover yourself for any losses or production time lost or costs that you will incur. So that's just the backup plan. Okay. Life insurance, that is something that you can take out on the life of partners in a partnership to prevent the unexpected loss of capital. Okay, so both partners invest, and now life insurance taken out on the partners, so that in the event of something happens, it is a prevention of the loss of capital. Now, if one of your key personnel should be in an accident or dies, then that proceeds of the insurance policy can be paid out to business beneficiaries. Now, what do you mean with the key personnel? That means someone whom the business really relies on to bring in income. Okay, and that's quite important. If you don't take out insurance on that, you will there's a lot of cost involved to get the person up to a place where he transfers all of his skills and knowledge to another person. So it's not always possible. So there's some type of insurance that you can cover yourself against that. Replacement cost for damaged machinery equipment, that's very high. So insurance to cover yourself that. Let's look at insurable and non-insurable risk as a summary. So insurable risk means the risk are insured, and the insurance companies will decide on the likelihood of an event and then decide if they want to insure. So they'll say, okay, you know, we don't live in an area that's prone to fires. We'll provide you fire or whatever insurance against fire, and the chances are that it might not happen. But in the event that it does, we will compensate you for that. Okay, and then the premium will be determined on that. That can also be for robberies or whatever. Non-insurable risk means these risks are not insured by insurance companies. The risks are too high, the costs are too high, and that will remain with the business. Okay, this is also that the insurance company cannot calculate the profitability of the risk, and therefore they can't work out a premium. Now remember, when you think of a insurance company, it's a company, it's a business. They also need to make money. Now if you think of if a business has to pay out other businesses big amounts, let's say I take out business insurance, right? And the business insurance is, let's say, 2,000 to 5,000 rand, depending on the policy that I take out. If my only income is, let's say, 5,000 rand a month for a year, that gives me 60,000 rand in that year. Now, I will be covered for my whole business, for my fleet. Now, 60,000 rand will not cover the damages if I am in one accident with the company vehicle, for example. Okay, so they need to ensure that they take that money and do something with it that multiplies the money, and in the end that they will still make a profit. So that's why they sell this product in mass to different companies and ensure that there's a lot of people that will take out this insurance. Now, this is all based on probabilities, okay? For example, if you take a casino, there's a probability. The casino's got the highest probability to win. It's normally a percentage of 50.05 or 50.1% that the casino will win in the end of blackjack. That's just stats that I researched, not that I know. Any case, so in these, this is the way that the casino operates and then that they make money from. But if you look at insurance companies, the probability that something will happen is the possibility exists, but it's not a high probability. So therefore, people will take out insurance because they don't want to bear the risk. Okay, they don't want to carry that risk. So let's say 1 out of 100 companies will then claim. If you have 100 companies with 60,000 rand a month, okay, if you do the sum, 60,000 rand a month with 100 companies gives you, it gives you 6 million per annum. Now you've got 6 million rand that you need, that you receive in premiums. Let's say everyone takes out the same insurance, okay? Now for that year, you will be able to pay out events, for example, 6 million. But do you have that 6 million in the beginning of the year? That's the question that the company, they need to have capital. So they'll take out, they will take out the loan probably to make sure that they are able to provide insurance for that. And then they'll pay out their loan as their capital base increase. But they still need to pay expenses. So they will need to do something with that money to multiply it as well. And I'm not going to give out the secret on insurance companies, but it's quite interesting. Okay, so just examples. Of insurable risk, that's like you said earlier, theft, fidelity insurance, burglary, money in transit, fire, natural disasters, damages to or loss of assets, injuries on premises or injuries on duty, IODs. Non-insurable can be a war, nuclear weapons or war, fashion changes, that's a quite interesting one. If you're a company that sells clothes and there's a sudden change in fashion and your stock doesn't sell, that's not the event that you can use to claim. Improvements in technology, that's something that constantly changes and you can't take out insurance for that. Irrecoverable debts, financial loss due to bad management, possible failure of a business, shoplifting during business hours, loss of income if stock is not received in time. So if you order and people want their products but you can't deliver and then you lose clients, sorry, it's not an insurable risk. Okay, I hope this makes sense. Your homework is to complete activities on page 5 of the informal activities 2.5 to 2.8.2. Thank you.